All right, here we go. Welcome to another edition of Pittsburgh Sports Line at Sips Sports Bar, 3024 West Liberty Avenue, 15216. That's downtown Dormont. We got a great crowd. We got a lot of guests. I lost track how many we have. We're going to have a special event here. One of the guests is going to give $100 worth of artwork away. And I heard Mayor Addison Brenner actually has about 20 of these paintings and sketches in his house. So it's just awesome. Now, I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. I got Smoking Jim Frazier. I got Chip the Prophet Hainer. And we're just happy to be at Sip Sports Bar. We got John the Tiger Kiger on the camera there. Aaron Ward and Devin Shea, he has the clock, and we're not sure how much time we have, but we'll figure that out. And we start at first with what's on our mind. Chip Hainer, what's on your mind?
Thank you, Alan. After another heartbreaking loss to the Baltimore Ravens, the Pittsburgh Steelers' playoff hopes are not completely dashed. There still is an outside chance that the Steelers will make the playoffs this year. Of course, they're going to have to win out. They got some help yesterday with some teams falling by the wayside. But I'm going to make this short and sweet tonight because I can't wait to hear what Jim has to say. But I'm going to award a special teams game ball to the only person in the Steelers organization that has figured out how to keep Jacoby Jones from running a kickoff back against us. And that game ball goes to Mike Tomlin.
Thanks, Chip. But I think that was on everybody's mind. How are you watching that big screen TV and you just luckily made a step onto the field? Well, thanks, Chip. Appreciate it. And now for all of you that are new to this show and actually in person here, we have one of the best opening performances, bar none, with Smoking Jim Frazier. And especially after a Steeler loss, just to give the setup here, he predicted 10-6. I predicted 11-5. I've been crushed for you know how many, a month now. But Smoking Jim still held on. He called their winning streak. And here's the setup. Smoking Jim, what's on your mind?
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine. And if you want the green.
Hold on, buddy.
You got the C Levine.
Like the Steelers.
Always like to start off each and every show giving a shout out to my main man, Dan the Man. If you like coffee, please order some coffee from Dan. He makes the best coffee on the planet. You won't be disappointed. Please take care of your bartenders and waitresses. Brandy and Kelly wave to all your fans. And if you haven't done so already, please grab a menu. 2 weeks ago, I had the best meatball hoagie ever had in my life. And it's because of the chef. The chef Pete is in the back. Want to give a shout out to my main man, international master photographers in the house, Bill Boyce. One of his models, Kelly Irish, and Wonder Woman, Felicia Ann. And Chip, did you know my best friend was a female?
I did.
And she's here tonight. I tell you what,
another. Hold it, who is it?
Yet another beautiful woman from Easton, PA. Gabrielle Baker, the touchdown maker.
And this is the third time she's got you here on time.
Although there is a little problem. They're both getting later and later here. There was only about 8 minutes before we started this week.
I didn't want to get out the car. Why does every player from West Virginia act like their mother and father is also brother and sister? Listen, I told you on draft day that Geno Smith was a bum, and this week the Jets finally benched him. Listen, Geno Smith, the former All-American quarterback from West Virginia, his personality is so strange that his mom and dad must have been kissing cousins. Listen, this guy last year, he walks around all the time pouting with his lips poked out so far he looks like a child only a mother can love. Last year he lost 5 games in a row. He lost a pinstripe.com bowl game in New York. He refused to play in the Senior Bowl game. He refused to go to the NFL combine. The night before the NFL draft, he blast the media on Twitter, and then he turns around and fires his agent because he don't get drafted in the first round. The last place you need to have rabbit ears is in New York City. Listen, New York already got a bum quarterback in Mark Sanchez who only plays good on Cinco de Mayo. Listen, Geno Smith is a diva. He's already predicted the Jets is going to win the Super Bowl. So now everybody says he's the next Joe Namath. The only thing Geno Smith and Joe Namath got in common is they both wear pantyhose.
And Joe Namath got paid for wearing those.
And he was better looking, too, from Beaver Falls. So. Thanks, Smoking Jim. You got to give me a couple seconds so I can hear again. What's on my mind is more on a personal note. I usually don't talk about personal things, but I rode in a vehicle with my buddy here, Smoking Jim. Took over an hour to get to West Virginia. No, it really does take that long. Even if you use your GPS, it does take that long to get to Mountaineer. He actually knew where he was going, Chip. Made it. No wrong turns. Didn't run out of gas or anything. Didn't need to call you.
Let me guess. He went west.
I don't think so. But anyhow, we went to see the Spadafora fight, and we were there, and somehow we got in. Our media passes worked. We were sitting in nice seats. Thanks to the WPBBF, the Western Pennsylvania Benevolent Foundation. They actually do such a great cause. If you look at our magazine, it's on the back cover, and all the officers, they take care of the fallen officers. 100% of whatever you donate to them, it goes to the fallen officers' family. So it's a great cause. We're out there, Smoking Jim and I accumulated new T-shirts, real nice ones. Paul Spadafora has a tattoo on his back. Somehow that was on our T-shirt, so it looked very nice. The only bad part about it is Spadafora didn't win. We thought something was wrong the way he was getting hit, and just how he looked, he didn't have power behind a lot of those punches. Then I read a great article the next day that he did have an injury. His elbow was injured. He did get some stitches and everything. Smoking Jim and I, he was trying to pull Batman, Wonder Woman. He tried to walk out of the place. I didn't let him go. I didn't let him go. And I know one of the guards kept trying to chase him. And he goes, okay, I'm going. I said, no, we have to stay. So we ended up being right. There's little Z just made an appearance. This place is filling up. You got to come out to Sips. So anyhow, we did see the fight, and Chip, we made it back in record time. About an hour took us back to Bethel Park. No problem with Smoking Jim. And you know what? He has the greatest treats. He gave me water and blueberry Pop-Tarts. And that's my personal story for the day, because he's a single man, has never cooked in his life. Mr. Puniverse is in the house. KSWA, here he is.
Hey, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Have a seat. First, introduce yourself, however you want to be called. I don't know. Go ahead.
My name is Mr. Puniverse, Bobby Atlas. Bobby's just fine.
Okay, Bobby. How long have you been a wrestler?
Since about 2002. The organization first got its start around 2000, and Through a wedding sort of drunken incident, I became involved in the organization, and I've been wrestling ever since.
Well, you better explain. Who were you wrestling at that drunken incident at a wedding?
Well, some of the guys.
I want to give credit to that person that made you what you are. Now, never mind. We'll keep what happened at that wedding can
That's
stay
right,
there.
That's right. Can stay at the wedding. I agree.
Because I know you do have a day job, and I was told to take it easy by one of your coworkers on you. And
absolutely.
You see how I just started out.
So absolutely.
I'll calm down a little.
Sounds
bit.
Good. Sounds good.
So you've been doing this now. How many wins do you have, or what do you judge it by, or
well,
you win any belts?
By my very character alone, Mr. Puniverse. I take a lot of beatings throughout the organization, but at one point I've actually held two titles at the same time.
Nice. In each hand?
In each hand.
Okay,
that's all I could handle.
It makes sense. One of the reasons I brought you on tonight, and I said we have the Fan Fest thing coming up. Why don't we get a little bit into that, because I heard that's a very successful event, and it's for a great cause.
Absolutely. Fan Fest is our biggest event of the year. Fan Fest is held for an organization called the Holiday Project. What we do is we try and bring in a couple ex-wrestlers, Hall of Famers if we can. This weekend we have Luscious Johnny Valiant's going to be there.
I heard.
Former WWE wrestling star Zach Gowen. And what we do is we try and collect, all tickets are $5, and we try and collect as many toys for the unfortunate as we can.
Nice. And then what is this holiday event? What's the purpose of it? You didn't explain that. To get toys to kids?
Right. That's what we're trying to do, Alan, is gather as much of the toys as we can and then distribute them throughout Western Pennsylvania to the unfortunate.
No, that's great, because we do a lot of fundraising here and helping people out, so it's great. That's why we want to partner up with you. What's the cost to get into the place?
It'll be $5 just this weekend, and then usually adults are $10 and kids are $8, but for this week only, it's $5 for every ticket.
And it's in Lawrenceville, right?
Yes, it's at the Moose in Lawrenceville.
I know the place. Smoking Jim and Chip, we got to go there. You know,
so everybody brings toys?
Everybody brings toys.
Listen, I let everybody know I'm looking for a black Barbie doll. So if you find one, hold it to the side. I'll pay any dollar for
it. I'll tuck it away for you, Jim. It's a guarantee.
What about the kids?
That's just for the kids. It's for the kids.
Oh, there are kids there.
Maybe we can exchange it for an autograph, Jim Frey.
Oh, now you're talking. They're in demand, especially from all the women in the city of Pittsburgh.
Absolutely.
When I traveled to West Virginia, I can't talk about it.
Same rule, right? What happened to West Virginia stays in West Virginia.
All I know is there were all these places looked like castles. He knew every one of them. You know what? It's a family show. We're going to talk wrestling.
Absolutely. I agree.
Sorry, buddy. It's all true. I'm known to embellish, but it's the truth.
Hey, what the heck?
Now, how do you work out for this?
Well, we get together during the week of the show and sort of go over some things and how we want to work things out for the weekend and who's going to be on the card and who's right. going to be facing who. Currently, I have a little feud with the VIPs, which I plan on ending.
I've been seeing online. That's why I want to bring this stuff up. What's this VIP controversy?
The VIP sort of took over and been riding roughshod over to KSWA, and that's kind of why I came back, actually, Alan.
So you got a little chip on your shoulder.
Yeah, I got a little chip on my shoulder.
Oh, sorry, Chip. No pun intended.
Pun intended, right?
No pun intended here. You're not little, and he got a chip.
But last week at the fundraiser at St. Maria Goretti, I just arrived at the show, and one of my partners come in and said, hey, your buddy's getting the crap kicked out of him in the ring. So I threw my bag down, run out, cleared the ring out. It was the VIPs again. And at that point, for us interrupting their barrage, we were called out to a Bloomfield street fight.
No. We want to hear more about
of
that.
Of course, which started out as a regular tag team bout, ended up a Bloomfield street fight, at which point my partner was changing in his own changing room, and I'm out gathering objects from the sports lockers. You know, we were getting bowling pins and home and away signs.
Nice. Any bricks? Any bricks from the old streets there?
Whatever I could find, I threw in there, Alan.
Nice.
You know? And my
You're
partner come out.
You're a creative guy. You're like the MacGyver of
my
wrestling.
Partner come out, you know, exactly. My partner come out, and maybe he thought I was taking too many to the head. He said, Bobby, what are you doing? I said, oh, you didn't hear? It's a Bloomfield street fight. Just turned around and went back in the locker room. He said, good luck with that.
Wow.
But it turned out to be a great match, and the kids really loved it, and we raised a lot of good money for a worthy cause.
Sounds like great entertainment. You don't have many scars that I could see here.
Well, they're just not visible. I try and contain them as much as I can.
Hey, John, don't get any close-ups of them here.
I had such a horn on my head on Sunday, my kids were throwing tinsel around it. They thought they could decorate it.
So you're like the Pittsburgh dad.
Absolutely.
Nice. What's your family think of your career here, your second career?
Well, obviously my wife's not too fond of it because being where I'm from, you know, I'm from every girl's dream, California originally. Woo. We moved into Pittsburgh and my wife's a Pittsburgher, so she's not into the flamboyance of the, right. you know, the whole title here. So
I understand.
Maybe about 4 years back, I broke four ribs during a match, and she sort of kiboshed that for a little while, but
Trapper Tom told us how this isn't staged.
No, absolutely not. Absolutely not.
Living proof of that.
Yeah, you're going to take a little bit of a beat no matter what.
One of my last questions, though. How did you come up with Mr. Puniverse?
Well, actually, it goes back to the Jerry Springer days.
Okay.
I used to see the guys
when you were on the show.
I wish I was, actually, Alan. I wish I was.
What's your wife think of that?
But I don't know. I'll have to ask her when I get home.
Oh, sorry. You know we're videoing this. Please cut that part out of this.
No, we're good. What's live's live. We're good.
But well, this is live but taped.
I hear you.
You have about 10 seconds to get cut. You already passed that up.
There we go.
Go ahead. Finish your
story.
In
all honesty, though, that's how it came about. And
okay.
When at this event where, you know, I decided I was going to get into this wrestling, we started immediately thinking about a name. And they come up with Bobby Atlas, and I said, it's got to be a precursor to have Mr. Puniverse in front of that.
There you go.
So for the first couple years, I had to sash and the crown, and, you know, once I won a few titles, legitimized myself, we moved on from there.
Nice. Oh, I appreciate it. Thanks for your story.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you guys very much. It's been a pleasure.
You take care.
All right,
thank you so much.
Appreciate you, sir.
Best of luck at FanFest.
Trapper Tom, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Al. Chip, Smoking Jim.
Now just give me a little setup. How would you announce Mr. Puniverse coming in the ring? I didn't want to even get into that. I just want to hear you, because this will be broadcast on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. And another announcement before we get in, because you're always doing shameless announcements. I just was told, thank you, everybody. We hit 1,625 likes.
Yeah.
We appreciate it. We're on that way to 2K. And speaking of that, here's Trapper Tom.
All right, when I introduce Mr. Puniverse Bob Atlas.
And don't come up. Don't come up. Sit. Stay back.
Stay back indeed.
Stay back there in your chair. Whatever you do.
And his opponent, weighing in at 369 pounds, from every girl's dream, Mr. Puniverse Bob Atlas.
Sit down. You're not coming up again.
We had to stop him from climbing over all the girls.
And that'll be on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. We've never done an introduction with Mr. Puniverse. Now you have it.
First time for everything.
Well, we're trying.
Mr. Puniverse did a great job here representing what the KSWA is all about. It is a organization of hardworking guys that love the sport. And perform and entertain.
And they're tough guys.
And are tough guys. 369 pounds, 4% body fat. Mr. Puniverse, Bob Atlas. He
can
even
I
gets
check your
too.
Glasses?
Yeah.
Let me just see them 1 second. Can I see them?
Wait. Every couple years.
Oh, yeah, that's right. He's 145 pounds right now.
They get a little worse.
Okay.
Get every worse.
Thanks, Tom.
But he did a great job talking about it.
Yes, he did. He's welcome back after he wins.
That's right.
Even after.
KSWA Fan Fest, of course, this Saturday. Before that, in Lawrenceville United, anybody that might be from Lawrenceville that catches this online, Lawrenceville United's annual Christmas party beforehand. It's a free thing for kids in the Lawrenceville neighborhood, and any toys.
What time?
You know, you're gonna have to go to the KSWA website. I was asking for the time.
Okay.
And they didn't
to
get
be
it to
announced.
To be, yeah.
All right.
But you can find the time on our website, and then any toys that they don't give away to needy kids in Lawrenceville, they give to us, and we give them to the holiday project,
great.
The Allegheny County Holiday Project.
That is great.
So, you know, it's the biggest. Our biggest event of the year. Last year, I mentioned last week, Lanny Fratteri will be back for the fourth year in
a row, Pirate Legend,
to guest ring announce for one match. And I think I mentioned it last week.
You can repeat anything again, no problem.
You know, we had last year, Paul Steigerwald was in the audience last year.
No way.
Just imagine me sitting at ringside, Lanny Fratteri goes, Paul Steigerwald is here. I go, what? And I look over, and there he is with a beer in his hand.
Well, how about when you go, Smoking Jim Frazier's there with all of his girls.
That's right.
His entourage.
What do you think's going to happen? Oh, sorry. Gabrielle's here. She said there's only one. She said there's only one.
Only one BFF, right? Right, Smokey Jim?
I don't know.
BFF.
What happened on that journey?
My best friend.
That was a long journey, I'm telling you, to West Virginia.
And also of note in the world of professional wrestling, it was announced last week that the Real Brick and Mortar Hall of Fame in Amsterdam, New York, they announced their class of 2014, and Demolition Axe, Bill Eady, a native of Brownsville, Pennsylvania, will be inducted into the Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame in Amsterdam, New York, next year. So that is huge.
Thanks for announcing that.
2009, he made it to the KSWA Hall of Fame. One of the nicest guys you'd ever want to meet. He's been in our organization four times. He's wrestled for us four times. He was at a fan fest a couple of years ago.
Great.
And just a terrific guy. And Pittsburgh, once again, will probably be well represented in Amsterdam the weekend of the Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame.
And I would love to meet him, because he'd be the first guy from Brownsville I ever met that wasn't a drug dealer.
Wow. He doesn't mean that. That's a disclaimer, folks. He's not serious. Look at that
serious face.
He's serious.
And we both went to California, Smoking Jim. So
you know what? I've been to Brownsville. When I owned horses, there were people that, they weren't drug dealers, right? They had families and everything.
But that was the big news. That was the big news last week. And, of course, Mr. Puniverse mentioned that Luscious Johnny Valiant, Pittsburgh native, he still comes to town periodically. He still has family here. He still has business dealings here, and he comes back
periodically. Did you write an article about that?
I did.
What a surprise.
What a lead-in.
Go read it somewhere. Tell us where it's at.
Actually, also new, last week I started Pittsburgh Pro Wrestling blog website. PGH Pro Wrestling.
Was I the first reader or second reader?
Then? I'm not sure. It's PGHProWrestling.blogspot.com.
And I enjoyed that. I'll tell you, that's great. We'll put up more links when you fire up more stuff there.
And I did a story and I posted it over the weekend. Zach Gowan, the one-legged wonder.
Yeah.
A great man of faith. A guy that was admittedly addicted to drugs and was homeless at one point. I don't think he's ever at Brownsville, though, Jim. But he went from Detroit, Michigan. He got on his knees in front of his mother and he said, I need help. And his mother encouraged him to reach out to the WWE, because 10 years ago he was facing off with Rowdy Roddy Piper, and he was alongside Hulk Hogan 10 years ago. He was out of work at the age of 20, unemployed at the age of 20. And became addicted to some things and said to his mother, I need some help. She encouraged him to go to the WWE wellness program. He did that, cleaned himself up, and he's one of the most sought after.
That's a good story.
Independent pro wrestlers in all of the country. Great guy, and we're looking forward to having him here this Saturday. Nice. Bell time, 7:30, KSWA Arena. You can go to kswa.net.
How much for these tickets?
$5. Please bring a new toy for kids.
You don't have to wrap them. Just bring them.
Just bring them. Just bring them.
Thanks,
right.
Thanks, Tom.
Thank you very much,
appreciate
as always.
It. Good luck with the Fan Fest. Thank you very much. Introduce yourself.
Hey,
I know who you are.
They
don't have a clue.
I'm Chris Nix.
That's Crosby, by Yager.
Pittsburgh artist. I draw what I call visual biographies. They take about 4 months to draw the originals, about a month or two of research, then about 2 or 3 months of drawing time.
What got you started with this?
I hated my civil engineering job.
I
wasn't a cube form guy. There was something inside me, so I would come home at night from my civil engineering job and do some doodling as kind of a creative release.
This is more than doodling.
I appreciate that.
This is so unique.
Thank you very much. Each one takes about, like again, I said, about 3 months to create. What you're looking at here is about...
Wow, look at
Tomlin. Tomlin's got one of
his. Let's leave that Tomlin. This was done. That's the same look he had on the sideline right before he got in the way. You can see this on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. I guarantee it.
I'm going to have to update that to put Stangate in there. Stangate 2013.
Let's go Pens. I like that.
Thank you.
Let's go Pens.
Thank you very much. And I brought all of these for you to give away to all these people here.
You know what? I may have to change a contest. I think I get one just because we're giving them away.
Certainly, yeah.
Yeah. But why don't you tell people what you want us to do? Right here, well, one of you out here is going to win one of these.
Yeah. Actually,
somebody here is going to be a winner.
I guess if someone could tell me what year Roberto Clemente joined the Marines, the United States Marine Corps, we'll be able to give them.
Chip, you're out.
What? I don't know if people knew that.
Who knows that?
I do a lot of research before I get done. And after
you can tell your engineer, you come up with a trivia, nobody knows.
I guess it's,
you know what, I'll just tell you this much. I did post it on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook.
But he's not American, right?
He's Puerto Rican. It's not our 51st state, but it's a territory.
Dominican.
Yes.
No, Puerto Rican.
He's actually in the Marines, the U.S. Puerto Marines Rican. Hall of Fame.
Really?
For sports, yeah. Yeah, Roberto is.
Yeah.
That's a new one.
Yeah. No, I'm just looking for exposure. I appreciate the opportunity to come and talk and be on the sports line.
Well, how long have you been doing this?
I've been doing this since about 2007. I've been drawing since I was 3 years old. But
really?
Yeah. My parents used to yell at me for doodling in my books all the time. And now I just recently got a note, thank you note from Art Rooney Jr., which is kind of...
I don't know if you can pull up on it, John.
Which is kind of like a Yinzer dream. I don't know how many people have a handwritten postcard from Art Rooney Jr., but it was about doing a visual biography of his father, doing the Chief.
Oh, man, that's awesome.
Congratulations. What an
honor.
Thank
you very much.
No, it's good stuff. Now, how do they get a hold of you?
You can look me up at chrisnix.com. That's C-H-R-I-S, last name, N-I-X.com. And the website will come up. And,
aren't you on Facebook, too? You know you're on Pittsburgh Sportsline.
You can always catch me through Pittsburgh Sportsline. I believe that Pittsburgh Sportsline likes Christopher's collages as well.
And so. Alan Levine does, too.
Of course. Okay. Yes, sir.
Both
yes,
of those sir. People do.
Yeah.
I stunned you.
I see.
Yeah, Order, what event do you have? December 13th. Locally in Castle Shannon. I drove by today.
Yes.
Calabria's.
Yes, the Calabria's. Okay. Yes, on the 13th. Yes, we'll be at the Calabria's.
Local restaurant in Castle Shannon.
Yes.
If you need a guy to promo some stuff,
I guess so. I appreciate that very much.
Because Dana's over there. She's one of your greatest promoters here.
Oh, she's the best.
She's given signals, and I just met her in person. You know, I've known her for a few months. So.
Yeah. Yeah.
And I did it without prompting.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
What time will you be there?
We'll be there from 6 to 9.
Dana, what time?
6 to 9, we'll be there. And we'll be doing a hiding. Basically, I'll take any artwork, and if you're going to give it as a gift, I'll be able to hide anybody's name inside, or Merry Christmas, Jeff, or I'm leaving you, Lucy.
Hand us one of those, because I want them to describe.
Really
Smoking
tiny
Jim,
inside.
You pointed out one. Do you want to show enough, the one that you were pointing out to me? You find it. I think a Steeler one.
I'm gonna buy that.
Heinz Ward.
Yeah.
Well, this will.
I'll hold it up.
Okay. Yeah. There's.
You don't have to get it on me here. Keep the camera away from me. Show what's going on here.
Basically, from a distance, it looks like Heinz Ward, but when you get up close, there's his mother's name in Korean. He was a quarterback. In college, still holds a lot of records at the Peach Bowl.
Yeah.
He was born without an ACL in his left knee. They
Did
thought
you put all that in there?
That's all in there.
I want you to point out. How unique this is. You know it. We don't know,
know.
It. I've learned it.
I'm better at drawing.
You got to explain it.
Yes.
Maybe a bid more. Maybe a bid more to buy that now.
Yeah. And
the
then,
price is going up. What is the cost of this?
They retail
if somebody
for 45.
Wants to buy.
45.
45. That's a heck of a deal.
Sure. And then I can
hide anything. You got infomercial out. Buy this now.
He's got a tattoo of Mickey Mouse doing the Heisman on his right arm. He was a consumer edge.
What didn't you put on?
Dancing with the Stars is even in there. So
wow! Oh, man, I love that stuff!
But the whole point is whenever I draw one, whenever somebody sees it, I kind of really want them to, you know, be amazed. And usually they are. And Tomlin signed one.
I can't
one.
Let go. Can
Troy
I put this
signed
down
his.
Yeah, I want to buy that one.
Okay, sure, right. sir. Yeah, definitely.
That's Chip. Chip, this is
yeah,
Christopher.
Yeah, Chip.
That's Chip the Prophet Hainer. His wife Stephanie there, she's waiting for me to say Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. Because in the bar, they start drinking for some reason when I mention that.
Oh.
Maybe we're up to 1626. I don't know. Did it happen? Did we get there? No, thanks for explaining all that.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, explain it to me again.
Explain it.
I've been around a couple years, so I'm flexible on my verbiage.
Appreciate it.
1628. Thanks, everybody that's here, because this isn't being broadcast yet. We got somebody at the bar clapping for themselves. All right.
Funny.
Does anybody have an answer?
58. Thank goodness for the smartphones. All right.
Who do we give it to? There were like three winners. That's not right.
I give one to everybody.
What?
Well, just pass them out any way you want. But that gentleman gets the Clemente, and then you guys pass
which
them out.
Which one?
Mario.
Mario.
Mario had the 58 answer.
Well, where's the
which one did Chip?
Oh.
Chip wanted oh. one.
I got one.
Yeah, Chip, you could take that.
Which one?
Yeah, that's all to kind of give away. This Pirates.
Clemente.
Let's just finish the Pirates' 228 years of history.
228 years.
Yeah, there's 228 years of history in there. Everything. They were once called the Pittsburgh Innocent.
There can't be 228 years.
They were once called the Pittsburgh Alleghenies.
Yeah.
Wow.
There's no way. Baseball wasn't even invented by Abner Doubleday. You know.
128. It's
128.
1882.
That's 100.
Your math is off, my friend. You were an engineer, but I can see why you're not an engineer.
I have an app for that.
Yeah. Hold it. I got a dumb phone, and it says wrong answer. Thanks,
128. Yeah, thank you very
much. I appreciate it. Check them out. Is there a phone number to get a hold of you or anything?
ChrisNix.com.
ChrisNix.com.
Yeah.
Tell them
job,
right there.
Yeah.
Great
thank
job.
You. We had a lot of great sports this weekend, and since I've been doing a lot of talking, I'm going to take a 10-second break and throw it to Smoking Jim and Chip Hayner. What's on your mind in the halftime show?
It's on my mind in the halftime show. Pitt Athletics, as a matter of fact. You know, the Pitt football team, once again, you know, came up short in another big game and makes me scratch my head and ask the question, why is this team bowl eligible? But here's the question I'd like to have answered for me.
To everybody here, here's
how
the question.
How many marshmallows does the Pitt basketball team need to beat by 20 points before they get in the top 25?
You can't answer that question because most of them are doing it.
7-0, and they're not even in the top 25.
Makes sense. I heard three more, but I'm not sure. I'm hard of hearing. Good question. Smoking Jim, what's on your mind, buddy?
Now my favorite Marine is Roberto Clemente. Whoever knew? Hey, one quick story. Everybody knows that all babies are born with three fears. The fear of heights, the fear of loud noises, and the fear of gateway. And seeing Mr. Brown, a former Plum High School star, made me think of one year when I watched Plum and Gateway play. I seen Plum come out the locker room so fired up, but Gateway scored 50 points on them in the first half. So after the game, I asked the coach, I said, how'd your team come out so fired up? He says, I told them they're playing the toughest, meanest bunch of guys you ever want to play, and the last 11 of you out of the locker room is going to start. So good job for Plum against Gateway.
How did we come up with Gateway during halftime? There's Penguins. There's even Pirate Talk. Thanks, Smoking Jim. And that's it for our halftime show. We're going to start bringing up some more guests. Whoa, Smoking Jim, it's been a great Thanksgiving holiday.
A little Gladiators of the Cage shirt for you guys. That's Look. The event this weekend. Down at Stage AE on the North Shore.
What there time the gates open?
Little Fracture City Garrison, Death Before Dishonor. See some great fights this weekend, gentlemen.
Nice. Where can they get shirts like this? Who makes these?
Fracture City Gear, that's our clothing line. You can go to fracture.com, F-R-A-X-U-R-D, fracture.com.
How am I doing with the PR so far?
You're great.
Okay,
you're great.
Just checking.
Jim teaching you.
No, he's too quiet. I can't hear right now. This is all what I remember.
But, yeah, things have been going well. I appreciate you guys having me on again.
We wanted to get you here before your event, Stage AE.
Stage AE on the North Shore. It's actually a real big event. We have five guys fighting on this card from my gym, which is the Academy of Martial Science.
Tell everybody who they are, because we didn't get into those details. And I misplaced the flyer.
It's because I didn't bring you them again. I'm a slacker. You do have one of my window decals here.
Whoa.
Fracture City Gear. You can get these offline as well, or you can contact me at Team AMS.
What's something like this cost?
This is a $5 decal.
$5 for a decal like that, smoking gem.
Yeah. Hey.
Wow. That might be a nice ad for next time. Wait, let me see. Oh, yeah.
That'll fit in there. That'll definitely
That's
fit
right,
in there.
Sports right. Line. December
That's
edition.
That's right.
Fractured City.
We can talk about that. We
Oh, was I talking business?
Sorry. Shameless.
I didn't hear anything there.
One of the best. Go to your guys.
We definitely have some guys fighting this weekend. The professional that we have fighting is Jason the Whip Willett. He's 3-3 currently as a pro. He's looking to pick it up and show everybody that he's actually, you know, meant to be there. You know, he's a tough fighter, got a lot of heart. He's also a Marine. So, you know, he's ready to get this done. We got Matt Falk. He's also fighting. He's an amateur, but he's also a Marine.
You got all the military. How can you lose?
Melissa Gastic. She's the female, plays for the Passion. She's also a soldier. She's in the Army. And then we have, we got Mark Lieback, Matt Falk, Jason Willett, and Donald Bard. So,
is he a Marine?
No, he's not a Marine, but he's got a lot of heart. He'll come out there and bang with you.
Hey, that's all we like to see.
Absolutely. And again, that's Saturday, December. Yes, it is December.
It is December. This is December
2nd. December 7th is the fight, Saturday. Right, so that's December 7th, and that's Gladiators of the Cage at Stage AE on the North Shore.
And what are the tickets going for now? There's still some left?
We definitely have tickets left. Okay. They're going for $35 to start, and they're going all the way up to about $100 a ticket.
And that would be ringside?
That'd be ringside and tables, exactly.
Sounds great.
Yep. So other than that, like I said, this is a great event. It's going to be seen on Root Sports, Fox TV, Root Sports, Fox, the CW, Tuff TV, few others.
That's
I can't
right.
remember them all.
Will it be broadcast live Saturday night, or is that on
I'm not sure if it's going to be live or not. I believe it's going to pre-taped and then cut down. But it's also, you can view it live on youfight.com. And it's a $10 pay-per-view.
Y-O-U Fight?
Youfight.com, correct.
Nice.
Yep, so you can catch it there. It's just like a pay-per-view event. You can view it online.
Tell me about your gym. What's going on with the gym?
The gym, that's the Academy of Martial Science, also known as Team AMS, and you can check us out at teamams.com. We're located on Camp Horn Road. It's just north of Pittsburgh, about 5 minutes. We got boxing, kickboxing, Muay Thai, grappling, jiu-jitsu, cardio, kickboxing, aerobic, strength and conditioning, kids karate.
No wonder you didn't bring a flyer. You can't bring one
can't,
for your
But I
can
say
academy.
It again if you want. We got karate, kickboxing, Muay Thai, grappling, jiu-jitsu.
You
strength and conditioning, aerobics.
Hold it. And Bobby Atlas knew but, you.
Yeah. You know, Mr. Puniverse, we're talking about him coming up here. We're going to do something together, bring it up, raise some money for the kids.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Whoa, 369
360. All 360 and good looking.
369 pounds of twisted steel and sex appeal.
I'd have a pose off, but there's no comparison. You're a monster, baby. You're a monster.
And he's hiding that knot on his head.
I got some tinsel.
They're still decorating.
I got tinsel. Put a star on that.
You know what?
Christmas.
That might be a great little event. $5 to put tinsel on Bobby's knot.
Absolutely. You know what? How about ring toss? No ring toss. I forgot, Mr. Puniverse, but we got you covered.
I like the ring toss. No problem. Now, your gym is on Camp Horn. I keep calling it a gym. It's Academy.
It's the Academy of Martial Science, and it is a gym. It's on Camp Horn Road. It's located right across from Custer's Ice Cream, which works out great for me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Work out, go eat ice cream, have to come back out of guilt. So it works out pretty good.
Good. Now, that's a great selling point. If you want to eat custard and not gain a pound, maybe even lose, get 3% body fat?
Like Mr. Puniverse.
So
yeah.
off of 279, you're going left down towards Bellevue, right?
Off of 65, you'd make a right.
Right, off of 279.
Off of 279, the exit's off to the left, and off to the right, and then you'd make the left off the exit.
Past the Animal Friends and all that other stuff.
Absolutely, right? Yeah, and it's directly across from Custer's Ice Cream. Okay. That's the Carmel Commons, 300 Camp Horn Road.
I know what you're talking about.
Excellent. Thanks for the directions. thanks for all the stuff.
Thanks
good
a lot.
Luck
I
this
appreciate
weekend.
It. Thank you so much.
Good
Come
luck
on
Saturday
down.
Night.
Wear your shirts.
Tell us what's going on in Amona V world.
Well, I'm just trying to make people healthy, and I'm taking one at a time.
One drink at a time.
One drink at a time. It's all it takes, yeah.
Nice.
I'll tell you what, it looked like a lot of the football players out there this weekend. There's some crazy stuff going on.
Yes, sir.
What did you think was the craziest? Because I know you're watching it all day long.
I'd say that either the Ohio State game or the missed field goal, 100-plus yard.
Yeah. I vote for
return.
Auburn.
Yeah, that was incredible. Some of the things that
the
happened this weekend.
The arrogance of Saban.
Right.
Did I say that on air? The arrogance of Saban to do that?
Definitely.
Well, you know what? To speak to your point about the two games, the thing I actually loved about both the games, coaches on both those games played to win the game instead of playing to tie.
Especially the two-point
conversion.
That
was the difference, is that somebody had the courage to say,
that's right.
I'm putting it all on the line, win or lose.
That's
and
right.
I'd like to see that.
Yeah.
You mean Saban, that's why he did that.
Hey, he was trying to win the game.
He had it won.
And we didn't. It was 28-28. One second left. 57-yard field goal. It was worth it. The kids get 60-yarders in practice all the time.
It was incredible.
It was worth trying.
And it all started on Thanksgiving. I mean, we will never see an NFL game like that again.
No.
What'd they get? They got three touchdowns in a couple minutes, and none of them counted.
And great they, point.
You know? You know, and then they go for the two-point conversion, and he drops it. I mean, that was incredible. It took like 15 minutes of real time, but I never seen anything like that in my life. I'll never see that again.
No, me too. I never saw a game like that.
It was great.
No doubt.
It was great. Now, if he would have been drinking Mona V, I think he would have caught that pass. What do you think, Jim, huh?
I agree.
Yeah, I'm thinking maybe Le'Veon Bell, his helmet would have stayed on.
Yeah, if his helmet would have stayed on, too.
Yeah, that's another one there.
Yeah, that's tough. Yeah, they said he's doing okay today.
He was out running in practice.
They said he was running, he was fine, but I guess you got to get hit a couple times to see if.
Yeah.
You know.
Well, who knows if the headaches will come back. Or,
right.
He was knocked out cold.
Yeah, he was out.
He was unconscious.
He was out cold.
Well,
you're
not
moving.
You know, the thing that wasn't so much the hit. If you saw when he hit the ground with the helmet off, his head, the whiplash effect is. I don't really think his head hit the turf, but just the snapping action of his head.
That's
what did the trick.
I do have a question for you guys. What do you think about the non-helmet-to-helmet hit? What is the ruling? I mean, really. Is there one? Is it depend on what day it is? I don't understand.
There's supposed to be one. They say it's pretty clear.
Well, you know, I think what the problem is, and this goes across the board with NFL officials in general, is that there are so many different factors that they have the inability to make a decision about something, and you know they just they hesitate because there's so much you have to process in something that happens in the blink of an eye.
Well, not only that, it reminds me of hockey, because of the time of the game, they don't make the call.
Yeah.
Just like in hockey, and the announcers will even say, well, it's the last 2 minutes of the game. They're not going to call hooking there.
Right.
Why?
Well,
I don't get
look
it.
Look at NBA. They swallow the whistle.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, that was helmet to helmet on the Raven player in the end zone.
Yeah,
should've
no doubt.
Called.
I don't get it. I don't understand.
Well, here, I have a question since you're talking. One of the plays that I never saw during the Steeler game ever, and I've watched thousands of football games, I never saw a kicker run up ahead. Unless the game is fixed.
That's going to be a first.
That? But I never saw a kicker run, even from the smallest kids that are learning to kick.
I was going to say, even Pee Wee. Yeah.
I never saw anybody run up. I don't know. Maybe you have. Chip? Jim?
I'm surprised there's even a penalty for that. I mean, it had happened somewhere along the line.
I never saw it.
But there's a penalty for that.
I've watched thousands of games, pro to amateur.
It's just crazy all week, Thursday on. If you're a betting man, you were sweating all weekend.
That's true.
Yeah.
And I'm a betting man.
He lost 5 pounds of
but
sweat.
But our lead pipe lock for Thanksgiving Day.
What's that?
The Lions took apart the Packers.
Oh, that was incredible, too. Got to figure it was 17-10 the last time I watched the game. And then all of a sudden.
Well, you passed out because of turkey.
Yeah, too much turkey. What's that stuff called?
Tryptophan.
Yeah, tryptophan. I can never remember that.
Well, you know what? You shouldn't have had the Mona V that put you to sleep.
That's right. I drank the wrong one.
You drank
Instead of the energy
bottle.
Drink, I drank to sleep.
Here, since we mentioned Mona V only 6 times, how do they get a hold of you at Mona V?
MyMonaV.com/Mario's Juice. You click on there, and my phone number is 412 412- 417-7301. Call me anytime.
Thanks
for having me again,
guys. Appreciate you being on. Welcome, Zach Brenner, back. Tell all your fans what's going on.
Just coming from over in Brooklyn. Me and Pops just fixed the furnace. Was almost not going to be here, but then I found out my mother and brother are in the building, so we had to pop in and see the family.
Lois and Addison are in the house. What a surprise. Your brother has a script. He's ready to come on the show.
Hey, you said he wasn't ready. You said he didn't look ready.
He didn't look ready. He said he's always ready.
He's born ready.
Not like me. But that's why I'm up here.
Well, if you save some time, I might squeeze him in at the end. I don't know if it's going to happen.
I set the bar real high.
I know. You're a traveling man and everything else. You were great in West Virginia. He was controlling security.
Yes,
security, everything there. He was all over the place.
Yeah, it's sad, the result, though. I don't know if you guys touched on it or talked about it.
I was going to ask you about that. What happened with Paul's fight?
Well, I don't know how...
He got
robbed. Yeah, I don't know how Smoke and Jim, you know, perceived it or scored it or took it, but I had Paul winning at least 7 of the first 8 rounds pretty easily. And then there was a 2-round stretch. Sorry, I know you're kind of disputing that. There was a 2-round stretch.
I thought he won 8. I thought he won 8 rounds, so how'd he lose?
But, you know, to Paul's credit, he got hit with a headbutt. He was pretty busted up above his right eye. The champion that he is, man, kept fighting, finished it off. But like I said, in the 10th round, it seems like, you know, the hourglass just busted and all the sand poured onto the ground. And, you know, like it was just slipping away for Pittsburgh's kid. You know, he didn't really have any pop left on his punches, and he was just hanging on for dear life. And I think those last 2 rounds are what cost him pretty much.
Your observance was written up in the Trib about he had an elbow injury.
Oh, really?
Yeah, his left elbow. That's why he had no power. We kept saying that he's hitting him in the solar plexus, which he did. He was hitting him right in the middle all day, and it looked like it got him earlier. Later on, it didn't matter that much.
Well, and then I thought with Morgan Big Chief Fitch, I thought Morgan lost that fight. I don't know how that became a draw.
Maybe if Paul won the first 8 rounds of the fight and he still ended up losing, maybe it's that West Virginia math.
Well, Chip, we're going to get into West Virginia math right now, because we saw a couple fights where guys were clearly beat and they got a draw. 2 draws in a row.
It was pretty bad that
night.
Well, like he was talking about Morgan, he's the big chief, and the Indians own that casino, don't they?
No, not that casino.
Not that one?
That's not an Indian casino. Your man used to own it, Ted Arnault. He's gone.
I like Ted.
Ted's gone.
He
got into some difficulties there. He sold out.
Really?
Don't worry about it. We'll go to the next subject. But no, the fights, there were some exciting fights, nice crowd.
I thought it was a great, you know, great night for Paul to prove himself, and he had his best shot in 10 years, and I thought he prepared the best that he ever prepared, and he gave it his best. And sometimes, you know, you don't get the result that you want, but in the end, on December 14th, Lightning Rod Salka fights on Showtime, so, you know, maybe there's a new...
Lightning Rod was there, he was in the entourage.
There's a new passing of the guard maybe now, maybe, you know, it's Rod's time to shine, and we'll see what Rod got on December 14th against Canelo Alvarez, his little brother.
Wow.
So tune in for that, and if you're in Munhall, come on by to Addison Brenner's house. I'm inviting you.
At Addison's house?
Yeah, he doesn't know this yet,
December 14th, we'll
December
be
14th. The Smoking Jim can find his way to Munhall, Pennsylvania.
And what'd you say, Zach? Free beer?
free whatever.
How's the food?
Food's great.
Is it?
Yeah, it's all on him.
Really?
Yep.
We're here.
They don't call him the $1 million man for nothing.
When's the 14th? What day is that? A Saturday?
That's Saturday night.
Saturday night, Smoking Jim. You better cancel all those events you're having.
It's the day after the Friday the 13th.
You know what? They can't fool these Cal U graduates.
That's all he studies, man. General studies. He pays attention to the calendar.
He does. And he has one on his phone.
So at least we know you read a calendar. You may not read a Sidney Poitier novel, but you will read a calendar. So that just makes me feel good when I go about my day.
Yes,
baby steps, baby steps for the general studies major from Cal U.
Where's Rod going to be fighting in Texas? Aren't you traveling?
The Alamo Bowl. I haven't made up my mind yet because, you know, we got prior obligations, you know.
I understand.
If something breaks or something goes wrong, you know, who's going to fill in for me? There's nobody to fill in for
Hold
me.
Hold it. Wait a second. They don't know who to call. Who are you going to call?
Flip it. Yeah. Flip
Hold it.
Yeah. And for those of you that I watched it. Upside down and backwards.
Yeah, you did.
Tide.
Yeah, you did. Tide works. Wonders.
Tide works. Stephanie, tide works on this.
Yes, it does.
She didn't see.
That's the phrase that pays right there, ladies and gentlemen, for all your home repair needs.
412-583-5047. Give Brenner a call for anything. He'll even show for you. He offered to take me and Smokin' Jim to West Virginia. Smokin' Jim said, I've been there many times. No problem. We made it.
So that's funny because I lost y'all following you back.
That's how fast he was going. Didn't you see how fast he was going?
I didn't know a minivan went that fast.
And he went and got me water.
I thought it was the magic school bus.
Well, you know what? I was with Batman, and I kept Batman there an extra hour. You should see the punishment you pay keeping Batman there an hour longer.
It's brutal.
The scars are so deep. Hey, but those blueberry Pop-Tarts, magnifique.
If you come December 14th, you better bring some cupcakes.
Cupcakes.
And you tell the boss, from one boss to the other, that we want some cupcakes on December 14th.
Get on.
Yeah.
Wow, I have to talk to my daughter, Casey's Cupcake Creations. Wait, I think that's in the magazine.
Oh, it is.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
I can't
There's
find it.
There's a lot of great stuff in that magazine.
What page
Did you read this magazine yet, Smokin' Jim?
Yeah. Cover to cover.
Casey's Cupcakes at the bottom. Hey, what page is Smokin' Jim's articles on?
Those are the only two pages he knows.
How many are... You know what? My magazine doesn't have that top 30. I've been showing it. I've been in over 150 places over the last, like, 3 days. Man, it's all ripped out. There isn't any Gateway on this one. They're all ripping them out. I got to get a better one. Everybody I see goes, what do you mean about Gateway?
That's the first thing I get asked, too, is the legitimacy of that list. And I say, well, the man that wrote it is general studies major from Cal U, and he went to Gateway. So what do you expect? And if we had five elite players at Still Valley, I would put out one of those lists in the next issue with five of Still Valley players
if.
At the top.
You said
I said if.
Okay. So, you're an honest man.
And I'm also questioning the five Gateway gentlemen, too. So, but that's God's country. We'll save that for tomorrow.
Edition.
We'll save that for tomorrow night.
Hey, and I want to shout out the Big Duke for putting it in the window there. He's shown it on Facebook. We've even had
Upper St. Homestead.
Yeah, friends of yours in Florida, Joyce. She got hers, your cousin. She got that in the mail.
Yep, we sent everybody down in Florida a copy. So
wow, we're traveling. We're gaining ground across the country.
That's my title, distribution, so I'm just
You're distributing it.
Yes, sir.
Doing a heck of a job, buddy. I appreciate it. What else on sports did you miss?
Well, I thought it was interesting watching that kick return in the Alabama game, watching Nick Saban's, you know, worst realities come to light. But like you guys said, I mean, it's his own bullheadedness and his own Bill Belichick legacy that really –
Chip was for it, so he's opposed to that.
Absolutely, man.
He thinks it was the greatest call.
Hey, I actually – you know, he went to win the game. Now blew up on him.
And cost himself a national championship. So,
well,
I mean,
you know what? You play to win. You don't play to tie. You know, that's how you win national championships.
But that's not necessarily true because college overtime is glorious compared
to
the pros. You know Everybody what? Gets a shot you know, and you keep going.
You know what? Going to overtime would be like in a boxing match, letting the judges score the fight. You know, if you want to win something, you win it on your own terms. You don't wait for somebody else to decide.
I got to agree to disagree on that one, buddy. Because college with Alabama's the better team. I feel that way right now, and I felt it way before. I think if they went to overtime, they win. No problem.
Smokin' Jim, you think Ohio State and Florida State is going to be a great national championship game?
No, it's not, because Ohio State's not going to make it. Michigan State Spartans are knocking them off this weekend.
Oh, wait a minute.
You heard it here first.
Talk about my Buckeyes. But I think Ohio State's deserving. They haven't lost in 3 years. They need to go and
match the firepower of the Seminoles?
Well, if Florida State has their quarterback.
Are they going to have their quarterback?
Yeah,
I mean, are you not innocent until proven guilty?
But here's my question. Who has Ohio State beat this year? Wisconsin?
Everybody they played. They play in the Big
They play. They play Penn State six
That's
times.
A great concert, huh?
They play Penn State six times.
Hey, Penn State's had a good year. I don't know what you're talking about.
Penn State who?
They had a good year.
They're still playing football in Happy Valley?
Their freshman quarterbacks played a couple great games.
I thought they
there.
Forfeited like 420-plus wins.
You know what?
Gateway has more wins than Penn State right now.
Here, investigate the Free report. Free was an FBI guy who hid so many things. It's a fact. He is not an honest man. I'll say it like I've said. That should be the biggest scandal in American history. How do you do something? You pay $60 million for a Free report, and it's false? Now, Sandusky's the devil. He should be, you know,
for
not
60
even alive.
Million
and
bucks.
All the people that have been with him. But you don't punish somebody and take all the wins away. That is no way. That's un-American.
Could you imagine the journalism you would get from Smoking Jim Frazier for $60 million? You might actually get that book that comes out every year at the Super
Bowl.
I got
to disagree with you on that one. We're gone. If I negotiate that $60 million contract, that book will not be out. We're gone. We already have plans. Sign the check.
I'll find you fellas down in the
you
Cayman
won't find
Islands
us.
With Tupac.
No, we're actually going to Belize.
Oh, you don't want to go to Belize.
We're going to Belize.
You don't want to go to Belize. There's some crazies in
Tupac.
Belize.
There's a couple areas in Belize that are safe, buddy. You can be security there.
You guys can be safe in Homestead, too, man. Smoking Jim got a
couple
of
there's certain areas of Homestead nobody's safe. You can't tell me otherwise.
Anywhere north of 8th Avenue gets a little dicey.
My dad told me 70 years ago before he passed away. Yeah. He goes, there's certain areas of Homestead.
That's where it gets
they've
bad.
Been this bad forever.
That's true.
But it happens, and it's no disrespect. That just they earned it the hard way. They worked hard at it.
Yeah, they don't really – what did they have over in Monroeville?
God's country.
They have a
Monroeville.
Mall. They got a mall and a couple things.
Hey, we're
going to
be winding down this show. Enough of the Gateway and all this Homestead. Tomorrow night they can watch you guys. Zach Brenner's back. I'm not holding all those certificates. No, there's only one now.
It's signed by Jim Frazier.
Exactly.
In which general?
We're running out of time here. Zach, any last words?
Yeah.
Okay,
just,
that's it. Okay. That was your last word. Now tell us about Addison's party.
Oh, yeah, December 14th, come to Mon Hall. Come to Fairfield Avenue Funhouse.
Thank
pack
you.
Pack the house.
Thank
Addison
you.
Addison Brenner will be feeding you guys and all the drinks you want.
Nice to hear it. Chip, any last words?
Yeah, a little shout out to the three remaining teams in the Pennsylvania High School state playoffs. Central Catholics in the semifinals. We've got South Fayette still alive. And North Catholic still fighting in there.
All right, we got to wrap this up. Smoking Jim, what's going on?
My girl Kelly Irish makes the best cinnamon honey butter ever tasted in my life. Thanks, Kelly.
And one of your best friends has a birthday party Saturday night. You better give her a happy birthday wish.
Hi, Miss Esther.
And on that happy note, thanks everybody for watching the show on Pittsburgh Sportsline on Facebook. Verizon 32. You can see us every Tuesday through Saturday night, 7 to 8 o'clock. Thanks, Dave Cable. Comcast 7, only in Bethel Park, because Comcast 7 is taken up everywhere else in the country here. And thanks again to Aaron Ward, Devin Shea, John the Tiger Kiger, Dave Cable, and all the graphics. And everybody here in the bar, thanks for showing up. We appreciate it.